everyone. By variant, I mean a predefined encoded version based on 4 bandwidth options and 5 constant rate factors options. So once we select the video in the variant, we'll compare them side by side and we'll send it to a video processing server, which will run the algorithm that Dr. Mantini has set up. Once that's done processing, it will return some data, which we will parse and then display. That data is a JSON file set with elements such as the image ID, the category ID, bounding box, and score of objects that the algorithm detects. Since multiple objects can be detected on a frame, what we will do is find the average score of the objects in that frame and then plot it chronologically. Once we plot it on the graph chronologically, we'll be able to compare what the average score is, for the video as time progresses. And then once we see the both lines, we can see whether the algorithm is more effective depending on whatever encoding that we chose.
All right, let's go straight to the demonstration.
So the way our sponsor has the video set up, they're organized into what are called data sets. So in this first column here, you can select the data set of videos that you wish to view. There's only one selection. And in the second column, all the videos in that data set are displayed. And then if the user wants to, they can select some different filters, which are available in the third and fourth columns. So here you can filter by the scene. Also by the rate. So these are just predefined characteristics of each video that are provided to us by sponsor through his API. So let's go ahead and select a video. And then here we are at the analysis page. In the top left is a video player, which is displaying the video we selected. And then in the bottom left here, user can select different bandwidths along with encodings, CRF encodings, which is a feature that the sponsor specifically asked for. Upon selection of those two options, the video will display in the top right. And press play, they will both play. That's it.
Question?
Yes.
I'm not familiar with bandwidths or CRFs. Can you explain what that actually does and what's the difference between the two video feeds?
Sure, so bandwidth is basically how much data you have to send each frame. So that's going to affect the quality of the video, as well as the CRF encoding. That's basically just frames per second. So based on those two, those will affect the video quality and subsequently the output of the algorithm. And then in the bottom here, we have the graph, which is displaying just the mock output. And I think that concludes our
big challenges we faced. Questions first, yes.
So the difference between those two videos is like the resolution quality of them. Y'all improve it? Is that what's going on?
Basically, we have the original video on the left, and the original video will most likely be high definition quality, right? The video on the right is going to be a lower quality. That's pretty much all it is. But basically, you don't want to send HD over like a stream all the time, perhaps. Maybe if you have thousands of videos, that would be a lot of bandwidth taken up missing all your videos. So the goal or the purpose for this app is to kind of compare if the lower quality video will give you lower quality results from the algorithm, which is displayed in the graph, right? So if they can determine which bandwidth with the frame rate produces, let's say, an acceptable degradation of quality for the results from the video processing algorithm, then they could choose that bandwidth and frame rate to stream the live video from, you know, the thousands of sources that the user may have. So that's pretty much what we're doing here. That answers your question. So some of the challenges we faced, we chose this project because we thought we could do it in maybe Java or C++, some other language that we have skill in. We found out our first meeting with our sponsor that he wanted a web app so it can be, I guess, easier for, let's say if a different user wants to like change it up, customize it. It's very easy to customize a web application compared to a desktop app, and it's very very mobile, right? So that was something he really wanted us to do. And unfortunately, we have very little experience with web development, so we had to pretty much learn everything from scratch for this project. And I think that kind of shows with the quality of our interface, but we were able to implement most of the features. Well, I would say we did a good job implementing like kind of what you wanted. Just the UI is not too great, but I think that can be improved like in the future. And so we consider this to be more of a prototype than a polished product. So a big issue we had was streaming the actual videos. We were not able to do full like live streaming. So right now we're watching a recorded video on a storage device, right? And for our sponsors, since they're going to use the app for their team locally here, I guess at the college, they didn't necessarily need the live streaming to be done right now. And so we compromised and said, okay, let's do local storage video only, and focus on just getting the communication between the algorithm server and their app going, and that's what we did. So for the time being, it only displays local stored video, and hopefully maybe one day they'll be able to change it, make it live streaming. But we kind of determined that live streaming was pretty much a project all of its own. So we're only able to do that. Let's see. Well, one of the other things, okay, so our sponsor wanted, he wanted kind of a simple UI at the beginning. Let's see. Right, we have the selection page here. And he didn't give us too much to go off of or work with how we should set the selection page up. He basically said he just needs a few lists to show, you know, what data sets we have, the videos and data sets and these tags, and that's it. And this is kind of what we came up with. Let's see, at the beginning, we just had made the data sets and videos, and they wanted some filtering for the tags. So kind of like requirement changes, right? That's one of the challenges we faced throughout the semester is he did want us to change the UI quite often, and I'd say that ate up a lot of our time, unfortunately. But
so we had a lot of trouble like at the beginning with setting up. The sponsor didn't give us a lot to go off of in the beginning. Our start was pretty slow. First off, we were still learning, right? But then second off, we didn't have all of the material that we needed to actually make a timeline for ourselves so that we could meet tasks and actually submit things. What we still lack is the API for the algorithm server. Live streaming, well, which is still not set up. And that's basically it. Like after we get those two and we get those two things to work, the final product will be what the sponsor would have wanted after the initial changes.
You guys have any questions?
Yes. You guys mentioned that you wanted to work with Java, but end up doing something else. Did you say that? I couldn't hear what you
were saying. So it was our goal initially just to do like a local app with Java, but our sponsor specifically wanted something that just played in the page. So that's what we ended up doing.
In the end, it's just going to be ran locally on this computer.
This project is just for his use, right? It's not really relevant to anyone else, I think.
Yes, that's correct.
So when you toggle through the CRFs, is the graph supposed to change?
No, the graph is just not data at the moment. So it's not any real value.
I wish your sponsor was a little bit more cooperative. And speak with you more open, but I understand that you had a quite difficulty to try to catch him up or try to communicate with him, but he was just many times he was nowhere to be found. I understand that. Having said that, I'm trying to figure out what is the difference between the presentation that you had today versus you had presentation last week. I just don't see any change. Is that correct statement? Huh? Oh, yeah, anything new. Okay, any other questions? All right, thank you.